The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment, heard on the official website of HEW Entertainment. It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beast! The Man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio, on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
It's the boy you never told I like you. It's the girl you let get away. It's the one you saw that day on the train, but you freaked out and walked away. It's the plane you wanna catch to Vegas. Things you swear you do before. Lose control tonight.
favorite Selena Gomez that has hit the lights from herself and her band The Scene. She is Selena Gomez, and I am your host, Jonathan Clark. Everybody is taking in all the happenings from this past weekend's Golden Globe Awards. Were you excited from all of the fallout? We have a complete review of the show on our official website, Facebook and Twitter as well. You can watch the entire show at facebook.com/HGW Entertainment with over 1,000 subscribers, and on Twitter at JonathanClark1. You can watch the entire Golden Globe Awards. Very impressive award winners and show in general this year, and I'm sure that a lot of fans are still talking about it as it's created so much buzz on the internet. This week on our show, as we welcome you to a very special edition of HGW Entertainment Radio, we're talking about one of the latest premieres from Nickelodeon. It's called Wendell and Vinny, and you wouldn't believe how many times I had to get that name of the show down pat before doing this week's video blog distribution, because I always reverse the names. Instead of calling it Wendell and Vinny, I was always referring to the show as Vinny and Wendell. It stars Jerry Traynor, and if you haven't seen this show, it is absolutely incredible for one big reason, and that is the chemistry between all the actors and actresses of the entire cast of Vinny and Wendell. What a great show this is, and I do recommend it to anyone who's watched the Nickelodeon show before, prior to this one being released from Nickelodeon. It came out in 2013, and in 2014, I'm expecting it to be one of the biggest and most successful Nickelodeon shows that they have recently premiered. They have Sam and Cat, they have the Thundermans, and this one certainly has to be within the top three premieres that Nickelodeon has done. No matter what you want to call it, Vinny and Wendell, or Wendell and Vinny, it is a great show. And it really provides you with a lot of comical relief. If you've never seen any of the episodes of Wendell and Vinny, I'm going to be throwing some up in the coming days on our Facebook page at facebook.com/HGW Entertainment, on our Twitter at JonathanClark1. And I want your feedback on this show, and if you think it's going to have any success. Do you think it'll have as much success as an iCarly, a Victorious, Penguins of Madagascar? There are so many that I can name off in comparison to this. Jerry Traynor has probably got the most going on than anyone who formerly starred on iCarly. He's got just as much going on as what Miranda Cosgrove has going on right now, or Jeanette McCarthy, probably even more, because along with starring on Wendell and Vinny, Vinny and Wendell, he has done voiceover work for the new animated series from Nickelodeon called Tough Puppy. And if you haven't seen that one either, it is a great portrayal of a character coming forth from Jerry Traynor. No one could have done the voiceover better for Tough Puppy than what Jerry Traynor does it, and I'm looking forward to finding out what some future projects from him are going to be, because he's just so fun to watch. He brings his character Vinny on the show to life just so incredibly phenomenally well, and I think if one thing needs to be given credit for, it's the fact that he has just embodied this character so incredibly, and that's why the show is getting so many great reviews. Now, maybe thinking to yourself, this is just another subpar radio show that's going to criticize Wendell and Vinny, but I have this to say to you in response. What is there to criticize about Wendell and Vinny, Vinny and Wendell, whatever you want to refer to the show as? I wonder what you think of this show, so give me your feedback on it. What is there to criticize about this show? Every show has a different message it tries to convey, and in the first season, I think it's a very powerful message this show is trying to put forth, and I see the message being the relationship between a nephew and an uncle and a nephew. What a great relationship we have between all the cast members on a story-written show, but also off of camera as well. I've never seen such chemistry between so many cast members. There are a total of maybe 6 through 7 cast members, main cast members, and all cast members have a certain chemistry with one another. I was noticing some of the scenes from a recent episode of Wendell and Vinny just the other night, and every scene had just so much chemistry between all the people who were involved in a scene, especially the scenes involving Jerry Traynor. No matter who he worked with, he always brought the best out of himself and the people that he was trying to support in the scene, which is great. So that's one thing that jumped out at me about Wendell and Vinny that separates it from any of the more recent premieres that Nickelodeon have thrown our way, is the fact this show has so much chemistry. And I think you can pretty much be guaranteed we're going to see this show have a probable future. And I was very skeptic of Nickelodeon, you know, breaking up some of the more successful series like Victorious and iCarly to start off new shows. But I'm not as skeptic as I was probably 3 or 4 months ago when news of these shows premiering first broke on the internet and on social media, because the shows seem to have a very good direction, especially this new Sam and Cat show starring Jeanette McCarthy and Ariana Grande. I wasn't thinking that Ariana Grande was going to stay with Nickelodeon, but with Sam and Cat and now Wendell and Vinny joining the fan wagon of recent premieres from Nickelodeon, fans of Nickelodeon TV series now have something to look forward to as part of your big fun weeknights lineups on YTV and Nickelodeon's nightly lineup in the weekdays from Monday through Thursday. You have something to look forward to now with the premieres of these new series, and we have promising futures to look ahead to for people like Jeanette McCurphy, Erin Grande, and of course Jerry Trainer, who also does the voiceover work for Tough Puppy, which is seen in the daytime on both YTV and Nickelodeon. So fans of Nickelodeon TV now have something to look forward to. They are on Facebook as well. I just saw the Sam and Cat page the other day, and I did a video blog on our YouTube channel about the new TV series Sam and Cat in its inaugural season at youtube.com/John.